Well, when I was a young turkey hunter growing up, you know, most everybody used a box call and or a mouth call. And I'm a big fan of the box call. And I also like pot calls and the surface striker type calls, be it glass or slate or aluminum. And I also use mouth calls a good bit, but I am a huge fan of using a box call. I started off with a box call. I've been fortunate enough to shoot a lot of turkeys with them. And they make a sound that, to me, it's hard to duplicate with a mouth call. It's a raspy, scratchy sound, and it works on the turkeys. They're great. If you got the right one, you can tone it down soft and call in the timber, or you can crank on it when you're trying to locate a turkey, you know, when you're running and gunning, trying to locate one in the distance. So I think that the box call is way versatile. I think a lot of people look at it, oh, it's just a beginner's type call, but I don't look at it that way. It's actually one of my favorite calls. When you're looking at box calls, you're basically gonna know you're yelping on it and cutting on it. It's not as good for the lower pitch calls, like your real low tree calls and stuff. But here's a series of your basic yelps, and you can change the tone by putting more pressure on the lid. And obviously, the faster you go, you can change your rhythm or you can slow it down. I like to keep a real consistent rhythm and a real consistent pressure on the lid. I like to ride my thumb on the top of the lid. I can control the pressure. And the old school days, you held the paddle like this. I prefer to take two fingers, put my thumb on top of the lid, and I can control the call much, much better. Just like that. So, you know, your basic yelp that you're gonna use in the turkey woods in the spring when you're trying to call up a gobbler is, you know, a series of three or four or five yelps like this. And that's your basic turkey language. And if you want to get on it really, really hard, you just increase the amount of yelps. And I do this a lot. A lot of people call it an assembly call, which in the fall, when the hens are calling up their little ones, they'll just yelp and yelp and yelp to call their little ones in, but also use it in the spring, mostly for, you know, for locating. It's just more yelping, more of a long, drawn-out series of basic yelps. You know, in the springtime, the hens are, you know, during the mating season when the hens are actively pursuing gobblers, the gobblers are trying to call the hens are trying to call the gobblers. I like to mix the yelping up with some cutting, just similar to this right here. That's an excited hen. Be it she's you know, a lot of times I've seen them do this with it's a territorial thing. They're running other hens off. Their turkeys are very territorial, or when they're excited, when they're going to a gobbler, and you mix those yelps up with some cuts, it gives it a little bit of variety, and it kind of puts a little bit of urgency in a hen turkey, what she's trying to accomplish to other hens or the gobbler. As far as to get a cut on a box call, it's hard to do it the standard way you use a call. You're better off to turn the call if you're right-handed like me, and just take the paddle in these fingers and just. That's cutting. And it also, cutting is an excited hen. And a lot of times they'll just cut and they won't even yelp. And then in the morning, a lot of times a hen will fly out of a tree, and we call it a fly down cackle. It's more of a series of fast yelps or cuts like this. And that's a hen pitching off a limb early in the morning, flying down, you know, to the ground. You know, when you talk about a fly down cackle, there's a lot of people wonder, why does a hen cackle when she flies out of the tree? Well, you don't hear it that much in the fall. It's mostly a spring thing. And I think turkeys are just super, super active in the spring when they're breeding. That hen's been up on the limb all night. She's ready to fly down and get her day started. And I think there's just, they're excited to get on the ground, and the turkeys are all talking to each other, and they just cackle when they fly out of the tree and going down to, you know, to hook up with the other turkeys. You know, obviously with a box call, you got hand movement when you're setting up. You know, we're in hardwood timber here today. Classic way to turkey hunt, you're setting up against a tree and you're working the turkey. Hopefully he's coming to you. And, you know, on a box call, when you're yelping on a box call and the bird's coming, you got to know when to put that box call down and watch your movement. So you, if you can't see the bird, but you can tell he's getting closer and closer and you know he's coming, I generally put it down, you know, when I think he's within 100 yards. And a lot of times I'll listen for him to drum. When I hear the drumming sound that they make when they're strutting, I'll always have a mouth call in my mouth, and I'll try to finish the turkey with a mouth call. But You got to be very, very careful when you're working a bird with a box call to watch your hand movement. And a lot of that just comes from experience. To feel the turkey out, you kind of gauge the distance of where he's at, and it's just something you'll learn over time with experience when to put this call down and get the gun ready and get on your mouth call to do the finished work. Well, I use two different types of box calls. This is pretty much a standard size box call. It's kind of in line with everything you'll see on the market. And then this is one here I'm very passionate about. This is a bolt paddle style call. I've been running these since probably the late 80s. This call was given to me by Dick Kirby back in 1989. Dick Kirby was a president of Quaker Boy Game Call, a very good friend of mine. And hunted with Dick. I spent a lot of time working with the Quaker Boy staff, and this call is pretty special to me. And what the difference is, it's a long, skinny call, and it's very high pitched. It's very shrill. Now, this is not a call that I'm going to use in a setting like we are today here in the woods. This is more of a location call. I have killed turkeys with it up close, but I prefer to use it for location, trying to strike a gobbler way off in the distance, or maybe not way off, but we're reaching out with it because it's high pitched and it's shrill. You'll notice the difference when I run it, how much louder and high pitched it is. And personally, it is my favorite locator call to use. Like later in the morning, I'm maybe, walking around my farm, or I'm out in an open field setting and we're in a pickup riding the country roads, trying to locate from the road on a farm that we can hunt. This is by far my favorite call for location.